be glad. And this is what we need to do, saints of God. We need to be glad in the house of the Lord this morning. Amen? Amen. God has watched over us all week long through seen and unseen things.
That's right.
I know I drive 45 minutes going to work every day, and I see a lot of stuff that goes on the highway. But I thank God for his covering, and that he has brought me back into the house of worship just one more time. Amen?
Amen.
So again, it's good to see everyone's face that is here on this morning. We are going to, without further delay, go right into our praise and worship. Right now, we are going to read a scripture. I'm going to be coming from Psalms, the book of Psalms, the 71st chapter, and thus the reading. In thee, O Lord, I do put my trust. Let me never be put to confusion. Deliver me and thy righteousness, and cause me to escape. Incline thy ear unto me, and save me. Be thou my strong habitation, whereunto I may continue resort. Thou hast given commandment to save me, and thou art my rock and my fortress. Deliver me, O God, out of the hands of the wicked, out of the hand of the unrighteous and cruel man, for thou art my hope. O Lord God, thou art my trust from my youth. I have read you five verses from the book of Psalms, the 71st chapter. The Lord has already blessed his holy and written word.
Thanks be to God.
We will have a prayer at this time. Father God, once again we come humbly thanking you for allowing us to see yet another blessed day. Father, we thank you right now for lying down last night and the early rising this morning. We thank you right now, Father God, because you encamped your angel around us and kept the death angel away. And we thank you right now, Father God, for the activities of our limbs on this morning, when we are enclosed and in our right mind. Lord, we come to give your name praise, honor, and glory on this morning.
Yes.
We thank you for what you have done, what you're doing, and for what you're about to do. Oh, Lord, we pray right now that you would send your Holy Ghost anointing down to fall afresh upon us on this day.
Yes.
In this service, Lord, we pray that you will move like you never moved before.
Yes.
Touch right now in a mighty way, Lord, because we know you have all power and the palm of your hand, and that you can do anything or fail.
Yes.
Oh, touch right now thy anointing, Father God. Bless right now from the pulpit to the back door. Bless right now everyone that has had the desire to come here and those that are on their way. Bless those that cannot make it on this morning, Father God. For you know where their hearts and their mind is. Touch and bless right now like only you can, Lord. As we continue to lift your name on the spirit and the truth. Lord, as we are endeavoring to go into this service on this morning, we pray that you will remove anything that may block or hinder us from hearing thy word on this morning. Father God, we pray that you will move it as far as moving as far as the east is from the west and the north is from the south.
Yeah.
Remove it, Lord, that we might be able to have our hearts pierced with thy word unto thee. That was something that will be said that will keep us throughout the course of the week, Father God. Until that appointed time that we shall be able to meet again, Father God. We shall continue to lift your name up in spirit and truth, give you all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory. And in Jesus' name we pray, and ask it all. Amen.
Amen.
Do you give
victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today. Victory is mine. Joy is mine today.
Yes.
Love is mine. Peace, deliverance is mine.
Yes.
Because I serve a God that sits high and he looks low,
yes,
has all power in the palm of his hand, yes, and can do anything but fail.
Yes.
So I feel good on this morning, church, and I pray that we will not sit in our seats of contentment, but join in the worship experience on today. Allow God to move in your heart on today.
Yes.
Let us bring joy into the sanctuary. Let us praise his name in spirit and truth. Amen.
Amen.
That is the time I'm going to turn it over to Pastor Reverend Johnson.
Amen. God bless everybody. Can you hear me back there? Amen. Amen. God bless everybody. I just like to share. If you're sitting around looking like you're mummified, amen, to ask yourself a question, is you in the right place? Because the Bible says, into the gates with thanksgiving,
yes,
into the courts with praise, be, yes, thankful unto him, and to be ready to bless. I'm going to say this again.
Yes, 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 yes.
The Bible says, yes, into the gates with thanksgiving.
Oh, yes.
Into the court with a praise.
Yeah,
be,
yeah,
thankful unto him and bless his name. Somebody say, the Lord is good.
Lord,
and his mercy endure for all generations.
Oh, yes.
God bless you on today. Amen. The Lord is in this holy temple. Let all the earth be silent before him. God bless you this morning. It's good to see each and every one of you. Amen. I know we might not be many in number. Folk is funny, but God is the same. Amen.
Amen.
And you better put your trust in God and don't put your trust in man.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. If you put, amen, your trust in a man, you're going to fall short. Amen. Each and every time. But if you just put your faith in God, I'm here. If I got to preach to myself, I can't even hear echoing. If you got to put your trust in your money, you're going to be, amen, you're going to be let down. If you put your trust in things and stuff, you're going to be let down. But I dare you and I challenge you today to put your faith, amen, in Jesus. Somebody say, put your faith where your profession is. Amen. We just can't call his name when it's convenient. We can't just call his name when we want to. Amen. We should call his name at all times. For David says, I will bless the Lord at all times. Y'all can hear the Christian story? His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Some folk ain't got nothing in your mouth, but I dare you to put a praise in your mouth. Instead of a pity party, put a praise in your mouth. Instead of put a complaint, put a praise in your mouth. Instead of weeping, cry, put a praise in your mouth.
Oh, yes, oh, yes.
God is good all the time God is good. Join it with me. We're going to sing one verse of Hold to His Unchanging Hand. Amen. We're going to sing one verse of Hold to God's Unchanging Hand. It's found in your hymnal. Will we all stand? Amen. This is a congregational hymn. Amen. Hold to God's Unchanging Hand. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Time is filled with swift transition. No. Promises or not, you keep your hand in God's hand.
Yes.
Amen. And you continue to hold on and hold out to your what? To your change.
Yes.
Come. So tell your neighbor, say, neighbor,
neighbor,
hold on to God's unchanging hand.
Hold on to God's unchanging
hand. That means unchanging hand means elder, amen. That God's hand doesn't fail. It's the same yesterday. Come on, somebody, today and forevermore. And that's one of the many things I love about God. God is the same. God ain't no fair weather God. God is a good God. God. God is a faithful God. Even when we're faithless, God is faithful.
Yes.
Somebody said God's faithful. If it had not been for the faithfulness of God, where would I be? But I'm sure glad that I'm still holding. I might be struggling, somebody, but I'm still holding his hand. Sometimes I get a little doubtful, but I'm still holding his hand. Sometimes I even get weak, but I'm still holding to his hand. Sometimes I don't know what to do, but I'm still holding on to his hand. No matter whether I hold on by myself or changing or by myself, I've learned to hold on to God's unchanging hand. No matter what the weather does, people would change, the weather change, everything change, but God is the same. And I thank God, amen, because God gives us purpose, gives us meaning. God gives meaning to life. And if God is in your life, amen, life is not worth living. It's vain, it's vanity, it amounts to nothing. But if you just put your hand in God's hand, come on, somebody. If you just put your heart, amen, in God's hand, if you just put your cares in God's hand, if you just put your hand in God's hand, God will never let you go. Tell your neighbor, say, he won't let you go.
I'll let you go.
God didn't bring you this far to let you go.
Now.
You should have been dead a long time ago. Ain't nothing so special about you that you're supposed to be here. God, amen. God is good. God is faithful. And the reason why we're here today is God still got something for us to do. So being that God still got something for you to do, tell your neighbor, say, hold on. To God's unchanging hand. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we just pray right now that, my Father, that your Spirit will just rest upon this place. Spirit of the living God, hallelujah. We just pray that you will shower down, rain down, fall down upon this place, upon these your people, Father, that a fresh anointing will fill this place, that a fresh, amen, perspective, a new way of seeing, a new way of hearing, a new way of talking, a new way of walking, that your Spirit, Father God, will lead and guide us, that the Spirit of God will fall fresh in this place and do what you do, Father God, that you be glorified. We can't do nothing without you, Lord. We don't want to do nothing without you. And whatever Holy Spirit you're doing in this season, don't do it without us. Oh, Holy Spirit, Spirit of the living God, hallelujah. We just need you right now, Lord. Sometimes we feel powerless, but Father God, with you, we're powerful. Sometimes, Lord, we can't see the forest through the trees, but Lord, you said faith is the substance of things hoped for, evidence of the things not yet seen. Holy Spirit, grant us your grace, grant us your mercy, that your people will find it important to be in your house, Lord, ever before. Father, your people need to be in your house. It is now, Holy Spirit, summons them from wherever they are, from the four corners of this world. Blow a wind, Father God, and bless us with a revival, a renewed, a restored. Father, people have forgotten you, Lord, but I thank you for those who still are holding on by faith. Yes, Father God, that you would continue to get the glory, the praise, and honor from the lives of your people. For this reason, you created us. For this reason, you anointed us. For this cause, you've appointed us and gave us a plan, a strategy, and a purpose. That all that we do, Father, be to glorify you, be to bless others, and to edify your glorious church. Holy Spirit, we thank you. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Searched all over, couldn't find nobody. Searched high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Somebody say, in your own soul, nobody raised. Come on, if you ain't bringing nothing, don't expect nothing. But if you bring in a praise today, God says if the praises go up, the blessings come down. I don't know about you, but how many got an expectation this morning? received something from God this morning. Some of you haven't even responded yet, but you stay in the house of God. It's the best place for you to be.
Amen.
God will speak to your heart if you just give him that chance. God will speak to your heart if you just give him that chance. Hallelujah. Because there's nobody greater. Nobody greater. Nobody greater. Nobody greater, Lord. Nobody greater. Come on, let's stand to our feet. Just put your hands in the air and just worship God. Just worship him. Just worship him. Not for what he done for you, but just for who he is. Hallelujah. Just thank him. Even if you don't know what to thank him, but just start to thank him. Start to thank him. Start to thank him.
A certain song, a certain singer. I'm here to tell you, why would
your pastor.
Right.
Yes.
Some folk won't even like him because he comes with truth and righteousness and holiness. Holiness is a lifestyle for the saved and redeemed. Can't come to God in your way. Come to God, amen, and understand that God is holy, that God is reverent, that God is sovereign. He ain't one of your homies or one of your chums. God is our creator. Amen. And I always say, as we move on, even though I know this is Willow Grove Presbyterian Church, this church was paid for with the blood of Jesus.
Yes.
These pews that you sit on, you ain't got the right to sit on them because they were paid for with the blood of Jesus.
Yes.
This carpet, this red carpet this morning, I know they bought it, but amen, it was bought with the blood of Jesus. Don't you know this parsonage of ground? Ain't no man own this parsonage of ground. This is holy ground for the glory of God. Amen. Can you imagine Moses said, amen, Lord, why don't you take those shoes off, man? Don't you know you're standing before the King of glory? Yeah. Amen. We come in here just kicking it, popping it like it ain't nothing. This is a holy place. Amen. For a redeemed people. And it's my prayer for all of you that when we come to church on Sunday, amen. Bring all your cares, all your burdens. This is a place where you can get exactly what you need and so much more in one stop. 10 things I can get today. We're going to move on to scripture. Scripture today will be read by our brother Scott Walker. Scripture will be the gospel according to John chapter 13 verses 34 and 35. Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
That was very powerful, brother. Pastor was talking about.
Everyone please stand for the word of God, please.
Thank you. John 13, 34 to 35. A new command I give you, love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another. Thank you.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Say amen again.
Amen.
You know, it's an amazing thing that sermon message of God has today. I pray. Everybody who is here today is supposed to be here. Amen. I believe that because you're here today, this message that God has, this is not a sermonic message. This message is for everybody who's here today. But most importantly, as Brother Scott shared with us, he said, love ye one another.
Yes, yes.
Mama, yes.
He said, love ye one another. As I have loved you. I wonder what happens, DJ Big H, if you say you love God, but you don't love your brother. Can I ask a question? Amen. The challenge is, it's true. Many of us don't even know what the true fight is against. But you're going to find out today if you don't know. Amen. Amen. There's a real battle going on out here for the souls of men.
That's right.
And don't you know everyone says, I got to get myself together. I got to get myself together. I got to get myself together. You can't get yourself together without God.
Amen.
If you could get yourself together, you wouldn't have been in the position that you're in.
Yeah.
Come on, y'all help me preach.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. God said, feed my people. Feed them. Don't give them no appetizer. Feed them. Feed them that which is good, that which is holy, and that is love. Without love, I don't care what kind of gift you got, Elder Ruggiero, well, no matter what kind of talent you have, if you have not love in your heart for somebody, the Bible says all your good works will be worth nothing in the end.
Bless your name,
brother. I mean, he said love.
Love.
talking about life. I'm talking about love. Love. Love is unconditional. Don't put no condition on it. Because if you do, you've violated the code of love.
Well,
you know, we put things on love. We put our little thing, we put our little twist on it. Well, you know, I said, well, I forgive and forget. I can forgive, but I ain't gonna forget. Tell somebody the devil is a liar. The Bible says, take no record of wrongs. That's what he says. Don't keep no record. Look, we got a Rolodex. Soon as you do something wrong with somebody, it could have been 10 years ago, they're gonna roll that thing back. Just like a car, they're gonna roll that thing back 10 years ago. And they're gonna go right back to that thing 10 years ago.
Right.
I remember when. Take no record of wrongs when you love people. Just love people in spite of them. Just love them. God will do the rest. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So we thank God for the word. Amen. We have a welcome address by Brother Kevin Franklin. Amen.
Amen.
Brother Kevin? Amen. Come on up here and do the welcome. That's that man with that nice white blazer. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Look at that guy. He walked. Look. You got it. Amen. Hey, here you go, Ken. Here you go, Ken.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
I wore this nice white blazer today just so that I could look decent while I was doing this morning. On behalf of not just myself, not just our pastor, and everybody else, all of the members of the church, not just us, but speaking for God himself, I want you to feel welcome in my Father's house. Amen? I was glad, too, when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. You know, this is the place where your breakthroughs are. This is the place where you can leave those troubles, where you can pray your way through, where you can get a perspective on how you are going to live tomorrow, through the week, through the month, and through this coming year. We don't know what has in store for you, but we know that God will be there because he's faithful and he will provide for you. So we're here to tell him thank you. We're here to worship him for who he is. Amen. In the name of Jesus, welcome to Triumphant Judah. I almost forgot the name of the church. Lord help me, Jesus. Triumphant Judah Ministries. We want to welcome you today. Thank you. If you feel like shouting at some point during the service, help yourself. If you want to tell God thank you, you want to throw your hand up, you want to tap your feet, help yourself. This is what we do. This is God's house here. This is not our house. It's not by our rules, but by his. So if he moved you, let him do that. That's what you're here for. Amen?
Amen.
Again, we thank God for his grace, his mercy. Thank God for that. Welcome. I said, yeah, next time you come up here, just remember the name of the church. Amen. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Because I only would have caught that. Amen. My late pastor used to always say, I would not have a religion that I couldn't enjoy. Amen. God wants you to enjoy yourself in the Lord. Amen. The Bible says the joy of the Lord is my strength. Amen. The joy of the Lord is our strength. Amen. Somebody said the joy of the Lord. What is the joy of the Lord? Knowing that the Lord will make a way somehow.
Yes.
So no matter where you're at, God is a somehow way-making kind of God. Amen?
Amen?
That's why you can rejoice no matter what you're going through, because God already knows. You ain't got a bucket. He already knows what you're going through. And all he's doing is sharpening us, preparing us for our journey.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen?
You ain't going through nothing just in vain in the Lord. God is preparing us for a greater place. Amen. Without going through hardships, how are you going to know what mountaintop experiences are? Amen. All of us want to be on the mountaintop, and none of us want to go through the tough time. Amen. We all coming up on the rough side of the mountain. Amen. That's the only way to go up. Amen. Because if you go up the easy side,
Amen. You better be careful. Tell your neighbor, be careful. Amen. You mess around, they ain't going that easy slide, side, and then slide down right back to the bottom. That rough side, amen, you can grab and hold on to something. Amen. Even though you're struggling, you're still climbing. Amen.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, said, I might be struggling, but I'm still climbing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So again, we thank God for that. Welcome. We're going to now have a morning prayer by Deacon Melvin Simmons. Amen.
Amen.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Let the church say amen again.
Amen.
Let the church say amen just one more time.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Indeed, it's always good and a pleasure to be back in the house of the Lord one more time. Let us pray. Father God, in your precious name, we pray that you continue to look down upon us and keep us, Lord, as we are endeavoring to live your name on. Lord, we first of all want to thank you for all that you have done. Lord, we want to thank you because you allowed us to lie down last night peacefully and comfortably to rest well. Lord, you started out our way to touch us with a finger of love to awaken our eyes this morning to see yet another day. For your word declares that this is the day that the Lord has made, that we shall rejoice and be glad in it. So, Father, we are rejoicing and we are glad because we can call on your holy and righteous name just one more time. Lord, we are glad because we are in our right state of mind. Lord, we are glad because we have a good portion of health. Lord, we are glad because we know who we are. And we thank you right now for your goodness, your mercy, and your grace. And Lord, I pray right now that you will touch those that are under the sound of my voice right now. Bless them right now like only you can, Lord Jesus. For you know what they stand in the need of. Lord, we pray that you will touch and bless those that are standing at the crossroads of life. Lord, we pray and ask that you will bless those that are behind prison walls. May be locked up or not locked up from your love. Because we know that your love made the sacrifice that we may have the right to the tree of life. And we thank you right now, Father God, for all that you have done, all you're doing, and all you're about to do. We thank you, Father God. Bless right now in a mighty way, Lord Jesus. Oh, somebody standing in the need of prayer right now, Father. Bless those that are less fortunate, Father God. Bless those that might be bereaved right now. Bless those that are going through or just coming out, Father God. Because we know your word plans that you will never leave us nor forsake us, not even in time of trouble. So we thank you right now, Father God. And we pray right now, Lord, that you just continue to bless us and keep us like only you can, Father God. And we continue to lift your name on the spirit and in truth. Touch my body right now, Father God. Keep me in perfect health, Lord Jesus. Keep my mind stayed upon thee, Lord, where I can continue to lift your name on the spirit and in truth. That I can continue to do what thou will have me to do to bless your people, Father God. Oh, keep me right now like only you can. And again, Lord, we pray that you will touch each and every member and each and every person that is in this place right now. Touch and bless their families right now, Father God. Near or far, bless right now. But we know that you can, Lord. We know you can do it.
Yes.
So we thank you right now, Lord. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you, Lord, for your love.
Yes.
We pray right now, Father God, that you just continue to bless us and keep us. Bless us, we shall be blessed. Keep us and we shall be kept. In your precious name we pray. And that's all. In Jesus' name.
reign in victory. Jehovah Shalom.
Yes.
My Prince of Peace. Lord, I worship you. Not for what you've done for me. Not for what I want you to do. But Lord, I worship you. Because of who you are.
Oh, yes.
Lord, I worship you for who you are. Amen. Thank you, Deacon Simmons, and to all those who have been on the program so far. I just have a few things I'd like to share with everyone. Again, God bless all of you. Amen. God bless. It's good to see all of you. Amen. Today. Amen. We thank God. Continue to press. Amen. Continue to encourage folks to come fellowship with us. Amen. Continue to be that shining star for Jesus Christ, that God might use you as a vessel for his glory to draw other souls to Christ. Amen.
Amen.
When you're living holy, God can use you. When you're living holy, God can use you.
Yes.
It's hard to be partying with folk on a Saturday night. And then for me to come in and to preach to them.
Well,
y'all don't hear me here. It's easy. I know I've been there. So tell the neighbor, keep it real, preacher.
Keep it real, preacher.
Y'all sure about that?
Yeah.
Amen. To keep it real means to keep it right with God.
Yes.
It's not something that's cliche. It's something that's still in reference to God. Keeping it real is keeping it right with God.
Yeah.
Amen. Ain't nothing else in this world real. God is the only thing real. He's real in my soul. Is he real in your soul this morning?
Yeah.
Amen. He's got to be real. And he's got to be living. He ain't dead.
Well, yes.
Anything dead, he'd be buried.
Right.
And stayed in the ground.
Amen.
Amen. But because he lives, because he lives, I can face whatever it is come my way. Y'all hear me here? Amen. To live a victorious life in Christ, you have to know in your heart, in your belly, that you got everything you need to fight whatever you got to fight. Amen. That devil had me on the run for too long. I'm here to tell him, I was once lost. Amen. And on the run. But now I come back in the name of Jesus. I'm fighting, man. Amen. Against anything that come against my God. I'm one, amen, that's been called to fight that good fight. Amen. Somebody said fight.
Fight.
Amen. Fight. Amen. I don't care if you ain't think you all this, all that. Fight. You better fight. He fought for you on that cross. He hung up there all night long. Got beat, was spit upon, was stabbed with a spear in the side. His own people. Amen. Cheering on one day was there. Talking about crucifying. Can you imagine how he felt? But he kept on fighting. Amen. Tell your neighbor, said, are you fighting? Amen. Are you fit for the fight? Amen. I ain't preached that this morning. Amen. God is good. He's put something in my spirit this morning and it's bubbling over. Amen. But I do know that we have a few more things we have to do. Also, we're going to be starting on time. Somebody say on time.
On time.
That means say on time.
On time.
Amen. We're going to be here and we're going to start at 11:30. I don't care who's here. Amen. If the pastor ain't here, you keep on moving. Amen. Don't be waiting for me. Amen. God ain't waiting for me. Amen. 11:30 start. Amen. And we're going to be good stewards of the time moving forward. So tell all your friends and family, we'd love to have you come, but come on time. It's 11:30. Amen. It ain't 8 o'clock. It ain't 9 o'clock. It ain't 10 o'clock. It's 11:30 service. Amen. And I know it's hard because we work all week, but amen. At least give God a couple hours once a week. Amen. Give God something, not just something. Amen. Give God your very best.
Okay.
Amen. And God will bless you real good. Amen. Also, we're in the process of starting a new members class. Gene, you, and Cal, and all those who are up, we're going to be reaching out to you soon. We're going to be hooking up a Zoom where we can start our new members' classes. Amen. Because it is our responsibility to feed you the Word of God, to prepare you, that God will continue to grow you. So within the next week or two, we're going to start our classes. Amen. We just are working on some things behind the scenes. If any of you have a talent or a gift, please let us know what it is. Because I'd like to see everybody in this ministry have something to do.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Pastor Corey used to say, but some get some, and some get some. It ain't so hard on some. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Some of y'all will get that later on. Amen. That means if we all just pitch in whatever it is that Alan that we can do, it makes it easier for all of us. Amen. Also, when you come into the church, the first driveway, if you're coming from the Martina Avenue side, you're coming in from the far side, coming to the church this way. The first driveway you come into when you enter, never come in that second. And even if nobody's here, come in that first driveway. And when you leave, go out the second driveway. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Because you never know, you take that corner, somebody can be flying coming out. Amen. And we don't want nothing like that to happen here at the Willow Grove Church here, because oftentimes they may be having service or doing something, and we probably in passing or be coming. But even if they're not, amen, this is follow the protocol. Amen. Also, for those of you who have not been vaccinated, amen, all you do, don't ask me, just pray to God. Just pray. Whatever God wants you to do, that's what he wants you to do.
Amen.
I don't trust me. I don't trust this country when it comes to vaccine black people. I don't. But one thing I do trust God. In spite of what we hear on the news, it is our churches that oftentimes is the information hub of our communities. Amen?
Amen.
And I'm not going to be a preacher or a board preacher to tell my people what to do. If God put on my heart to tell you to do it, then I will tell you. But what you do in the meantime, you pray to God and ask him what he wants you to do.
Amen.
Step further, I've taken mine.
Amen.
I have to be real about it. Because guess what? We've been lied to for a long time. But the bottom line is, I've taken mine. My wife has taken hers.
Amen.
I'm still feeling a little Scooby-Doo-ish. I'm still feeling a little tired and woozy, but I'd rather be tired and woozy than to be on life support and we're not breathing.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
So we have to look past cultural norms and standards. Amen. We got to look past what we think or what we always thought. You have to do what God put on your heart to do. That's the best thing you could ever do.
Amen.
Other than that, God bless all of you. Let us, for those who are here today, let us continue to encourage others to come and to fellowship with us here at the Triumphant Judah Praise Ministries. Also, our podcast is on Thursdays. Brother Norman Bradley's here, as well as DJ Big H. They're doing great work with us. I'm going to be talking to them. I might cut it down maybe to twice a month. I want to focus more on this ministry. Amen. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Brother Norman has opened the door, and I can't thank him enough. And DJ Big H. Those brothers, what they're doing for us here at the Triumphant Judah Praise Ministry is not for cost. They're doing what they do. Now, don't get me wrong, Brother Norman said, we need to do a little bit better. Brother Norman said, we can do a little better. And then DJ BH, but you know what? They didn't press the envelope. They didn't press the envelope, so we don't need to do it either. Amen?
Amen.
So we thank God for our brothers, and we also thank God for, our Presbyterian deacon, Elder August Gerald. Amen. Who's back there in the back. I wouldn't expect anything different to see him than not to see him back there. Amen. So we thank God for that as well. So at this time, we prepare for offering. Amen. We're in good time, but amen, we need to speed it up a little bit. Amen. Amen. For those who are in charge, will you please walk lively? Amen. If you walk slow to the money plate comes slow out the pocket. Amen. Amen. Amen.
person after
person, and all the weight is on them. I married Tony and her husband, and that's when I first met Mother, Mother Bryce. Mother Bryce is a trooper. She has lost two children. Mother Bryce is holding on, and her husband, Tony, has lost about 7-8 people in her life within the last year. And so it's always been going through. She said she don't understand, but she said the devil is not going to cause her to go back to what she used to do. Y'all need to say something here.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So all your burdens, amen, let's just pray. Father, as we come at this time, Father, you are a burden bearer. Father, the hearts of your people are heavy. I don't know the concerns exactly of those who are in this circle. But Father God, you said, where two or more in the midst, there I am. And so Lord, here you are, standing right by our side, holding us up by the strength of your power. Even when our knees are feeble and weak, Lord, you are still strong. And Lord, sometimes we want to wonder how we made it over. Sometimes they just want to wonder how we still stand. Oh Lord, because the Bible says that you are able to keep us from falling and still able to present us spotless before your throne with exceeding joy. Oh Lord, look down upon your people. I know you sit high, Lord, and I know that you look low. Lord, look down upon the lowest state of your people. Lord, you are a problem solver. You're a heart fixer. You're a mind regulator. Lord, you're an on-time God. Lord, you are a great, mighty meeting post. You're a midnight rider. Whatever it is, Lord, that we need, you said, I am. So, Lord, whatever it is that your people need, Father God, remind them that you are and you always shall be. Amen. You are all sufficiency. There's nothing, Lord, that you're deficient in. There's no earthly problem that you already don't know about, that you already have not cured. So, Lord, I pray that you take, that we take this moment, Father God, to cast our burdens upon you because you care for us. That we cast all our worries and doubts and fears, even if sometimes we want to hold them all because we're afraid to let them go. Give us the strength to let go and to let you have your way. Sometimes things in this life are too big for us. Oh Lord, but when they're too big for us, they're never too big for you. You specialize in big things. So Lord, when we can't handle them, we can just tell that old devil. We can tell that circumstance, I'm going to tell my daddy on you. My daddy cares for me. My daddy loves me. My daddy's not a deadbeat daddy, but my daddy loves me so much that he's willing to do all things to bless us. And so, Father God, if you don't bless us in the way we've been asking you, Lord, give us the strength to understand that maybe you have a better purpose. Maybe you have a better way. And Father God, while we're waiting on you, I pray that we be of good courage to know that, Father, you said, when the time is right, you will come through. We'll come through this storm. We'll come through this situation. We'll come through that circumstance with new sound victory and joy, knowing that the Lord has done it yet once again. And we thank you for the healing. We thank you for deliverance. We thank you for joy and peace in the midst of the storm. And we thank you, Lord, that we can worship you even in times of doubt, even in times of uncertainty, even in times, Father God, when we don't know what to do, we can still worship you. Because you're the same yesterday and forevermore. Father, I ask that you remember Tony and Mother Bryce and Jeannie and Deacon Simmons and Brother Allen and all those who are here. Some people don't think they need prayer or their occasional prayers. But Lord, I thank you for an everyday prayer. I thank you for an everyday dependence. Lord, we depend on you every day. In good days, in rainy days, in tough days, in trying days, we need you, Lord, every day, Lord. Be merciful to your people. We can't make it in this life without you, but with you, we are more than conquerors. And we want to thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's give God a hand of praise. Amen. Give God a hand of praise. Amen. God is good. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. this time, amen, we're going to have a youthful inspirational word by Stephon Johnson. Amen. We're going to have a youthful inspirational word by Stephon Johnson. Amen. Amen. Amen.
I'll be reading Ephesians 6, verses 1 through 3. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor thy father and mother, which is the first commandment, with promise, that it may be well with thee, and thou mayest live long on the earth. As youth, we can honor and serve the Lord when we obey our parents. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. Come on, somebody. Listen, you know, the streets are clapping for our kids louder than that. Can I say it again? The streets clap for our kids louder than that. Wonder where our kids are. I remember there was a time, DJ BH, Brother Norman, I remember there was a time. I don't know if y'all remember. I remember there was a time, amen, where you ain't had no choice but to go to church. Some of y'all looking at me like y'all are speaking. I told you I speak different languages. I hit it out on you. No matter what language it is, it still says the same. Amen. There's no way in the world that you can be in church on Sunday and your kids are laying up in your house. I said, there's no way.
Let me see,
you may not say it like this. Why is we compromising with our kids? Amen. If you love your children, you would bring them to church. Amen. When they get up a certain age, they may stray and they may want to do things differently, but guess what? God said they won't depart. God is saying, if you don't care about your kids, then what you looking at me for? Amen. He said, train them up in the way they should go. He said, should go. They ain't gonna want to do it. That's why he said, should go. Amen. Amen. We thank God for all of you, amen, who are here. I just admonish people to bring their kids. I appreciate that. I love it. I thank God for it, because God's going to bless you for bringing your kids, your grandkids to church. Amen. Amen. My son played baseball. He played all day yesterday, but I told him, you know what? He going to be in church all day today. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen again.
Amen.
Amen. Lay up in my house. Amen. My pork chop, bro. Oh, my steak meat, my collard greens. I'm talking about he ain't going to go to church. But I think I got a good son. I'm going to give him no problems. Thank God. Amen. He mumbled a little bit, but that's all right. As long as I don't hear him mumble, amen. Amen. He doesn't give me too much of a problem when it comes to church. He's ready to go. Amen. So at this time, we're going to have a short selection, and then the next word you hear will be from the Word of God, from the man of God. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, you don't know nothing about that. Come on, somebody. Listen to these words.
Tell me what you see when I pass by. Shadow of a cloud.
Jesus, the glorious Christ, we do pray. Amen. I'm going to be reading for you here, and you can remain seated over in 2 Corinthians 10, verses 2 through 5. Amen. But I beseech you that I may not be bold when I am present with that confidence, wherewith I think to be bold against some, which think of us as if we walked according to the flesh. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war against the flesh. I'm going to say that again. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. Verse 4, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. Y'all have me preach this here. But are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations, every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. Boy, 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 tell you, it's better. Let's go over to Ephesians. Ephesians chapter 6. Amen. Ephesians chapter 6. Let's go over to verse 10. And it says, finally, my brother, let me say finally. So this is a summation of everything that has already been said. Finally, my brother, be what? Strong in the Lord. And in be strong in the Lord. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Amen? Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we what? Wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, powers, against rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. God has given me this morning's message. Jesus is my weapon of choice. Y'all will help me preach this here. Some of y'all looking like you're in a fog. Amen. Jesus is my weapon of choice. Now, we all know about fighting. Amen. We all know about putting up the deuce. We all know what it means to scuffle and scrap against something that we got an issue with. You know, boxers, when they fight, amen, they put on boxing gloves. Amen. But you know, football players, when they play football, they put on a football uniform. Mm-hmm. Amen. They need these weapons and these equipments, amen, to be able to perform, amen, to a higher level. Amen. But I'm here to tell you this morning that Jesus is my weapon of choice. Now watch this. I'm going to just jack this thing up real quick and then we're going to be out of here. I want you to know, amen, the Bible says this. Tell your neighbor that the Bible is right. I don't need no runway this morning, amen. Y'all just help me a little bit. I can feel the engines revving right now. But if you go to Ephesians, it says it right here. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood. And know what that means? Amen. Very simple. Tell your neighbor, very simple. If you can just get this, we can go home in 5 minutes. If we can just, amen, just move past arrogance and pride, amen, and receive what the Lord says about the kind of fight that we're in. Don't you know, amen, now that you're a child of God, amen, you better be ready for a fight. Now that you represent Jesus Christ, everything will come at you but the kitchen sink. And don't you know, he says, what comes after us, amen, we cannot see. Amen, he says, what we fight against is not flesh, is not blood. It's about principalities and powers of wickedness and how it's a spiritual battle. How are you going to bring, amen, your attitude to a spiritual battle? You're going to get run over. How are you going to bring what you think to a spiritual battle? You're going to get thrown under the bus. How are you going to bring what you might think and what you might want to do to a spiritual battle? You're going to get worn out. How are you going to bring, amen, anything to a spiritual battle other than Jesus? Don't you know if you represent Jesus Christ, amen, the devil is against you, the devil hates you, he don't want nothing to do with you, and he wants to do everything he can, amen, to destroy you, to divide you, to conquer you, and to cause you to doubt the God of your salvation. Tell your neighbor, say, Jesus is my weapon of choice. I don't know about you, so in other words, my fight normally ain't against me and you. You know how folk get attitudes against one another. Folk don't like one another. Folk fall out with one another. Amen. It's not the person that got the problem. It's the influence behind the person. Come on, somebody. Don't you know the influence behind the person? Amen. It got nothing to do with the person. The person just put themselves in a position to be used by the enemy. Amen. It's a terrible thing to be in the church and to have to suffer, amen, blows from people you praying with. It's a tough thing to be in the church and have to fight and argue and preach every week about unity and love in the church. Amen. And don't even realize that's not what the fight is against. Amen. The fight is not against the deacon and the usher. The fight is not against the elder and the pastor. The fight is not against the choir and the congregation. The fight is not against a brother and a sister in Christ. The Bible says the fight, amen, is against spiritual wickedness in high places. Don't you know spiritual warfare? Amen. Spiritual warfare with spiritual has spiritual enemies and it's for a spiritual purpose. Don't you know now that God is going to use you? Amen. The devil is afraid of you. You might not think you got no power. You might not think that you're all that. But amen. There's something about what that devil sees on you. He sees the hand of God on you. And automatically you pose a threat. Amen. To the enemy. Some of us think we was fighting. Amen. Don't even know what we're fighting against, but I'm here to tell you, amen, that when you serve Jesus Christ, amen, you need to have the right stuff. You can't bring, amen, no bow and arrow to no gunfight. Amen. You can't bring, amen, you can't bring no bare knuckles, amen, to a fight where you need spiritual weapons. Don't you know Jesus, even in his earthly life, Jesus relied on spiritual, amen, spiritual weapons. Amen, to overcome, amen, evil. He didn't come, amen, fighting one hand with the other. Jesus came humble, meek, mild, and lowly. Amen, the devil comes and wants to fight. Amen, he wants to overpower you. He wants to dominate you. He wants to outmaneuver you. He wants to manipulate you. He wants you to feel that you ain't worth nothing and God can't use you. But I'm here to tell you, amen, Jesus says, amen, this is how you fight this good fight. He said, first of all, you got to know that you are a child of God. Number two, you need to know, amen, that God who called you is faithful. Another thing you need to know that, amen, that God for you is greater than the world against you. Y'all gonna help me preach here. Amen. If you feel that you ain't got no power, guess what? You ain't got no power. But if God said you got power, amen, you got power. But you can have power and don't know that you got it. But I want you to know today that you got power, amen, and you got authority. I want you to know today that Jesus is my weapon of choice. I don't know about you, amen, but I really realize that I'm not fighting against you. I realize I'm not fighting against the world. I realize that there's a devil out there, amen, that doesn't want to see you prosper, don't want to see you glorify God, don't want to see you be a blessing to nobody else, doesn't want to see you say nothing for God. Anything in your life that puts itself up above God, amen, you need to cast it down. How do you cast that thing down? You speak the word of God to it. Don't you know that all you got to do is speak the word of God into your situation? What are you talking about, preacher? Well, there are spiritual weapons that I want you to know, and we'll close, amen. Number one, let me hear you say the word of God. The word of God means that amen, that when you speak the word of God has all power. So doesn't much matter what devil, amen, comes against you. Doesn't matter what trial, what tribulation. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, speak the word of God. The word of God will change that situation. The word of God will change that circumstance. The word of God has all power. Somebody say all power.
All power.
It is the word of God. And he say prayer. Prayer changes things. How many know, amen, stop asking somebody else to pray for you. You pray for yourself. For prayer has power. And if you pray, amen, and if you pray and pray right, God said the persistent, fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much. Tell somebody prayer. Somebody say thanksgiving. Be thankful to God, amen, in all situations and all circumstances. Just say, Lord, thank you. That's all you have to do. Lift your hands in the air, no matter what you're going through, no matter what it looks like. Just say, Lord, I thank you in spite of it all. I just give you glory. I give you praise. That'll cause the enemy, amen, to have to back up and look at the situation. See, you put him on the run. You put him on the, amen, on the defensive. It's time out for us to be running from the devil, fleeing from the devil, scared about the devil, when God gave us all this power and God gave us all the weaponry we need to fight this fight. How could you be losing a fight that Jesus said you've been called to win? Tell your neighbor, say, Jesus is my weapon of choice. I don't know what your weapon of choice might be, but all you need is Jesus. Jesus is more than enough. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Let me hear you say, amen, Jesus is my weapon of choice. Yes, he's my weapon of choice. Watch this. Why don't you try your testimony? Somebody say your testimony. You know, it's an amazing thing when folks say, stop telling your testimony. I said, the devil is a liar, because my testimony is what God has done for me, where God has brought me from. My testimony, amen, talks about the power of God. The testimony talks about the relevance of my call. Amen. And without a test, there's no testimony. But I'm here to tell you, I got a testimony to know, amen, that God is my weapon of choice. If it had not been for the Lord on my side, where would I be? He is my weapon of choice. Somebody say worship. I feel it here. I'm going to close here. Now, let me just say worship. Worship him, amen, for who he is. Amen. In the midst of adversity, just start worshiping him. In the midst of hardship, just start worshiping him. Start praising him. Amen. The enemy won't understand, because when he thinks he's got you, amen, he doesn't realize that, amen, your praise is powerful. Your praise, somebody asked Paul and Silas about praise. It was about to get it, amen, in that Philippian jail. But they began to praise and pray unto God. Tell your neighbor, say, pray and praise. I'm talking about weapons that you use in this life so that you stop getting beat up, stop getting thrown under the bus, amen, stop getting rolled over and then going to God crying. God says, why are you doing all this complaining and crying when I've given you, amen, everything you need to overcome? Tell your neighbor, I got what it takes. I'm built for this, amen. Jesus is my weapon of choice. We're fighting, amen, a spiritual fight. Don't you know what we fight against? We can't see. So how can you fight against an enemy you can't see? That means you need a God, amen. Y'all don't hear me here. We need a God, amen, who, yet he is invisible, but yet he's visible in each and every one of us. And he wants us to glorify him by fighting the good fight. Tell your neighbor, it's a good old fight when you fight for the Lord. Hallelujah. When folk, amen, doubt you and talk about you, amen, Jesus is my weapon of choice. Amen. God says, love them in spite of them. That's my weapon of choice. Love is my weapon of choice. Somebody say, love is my weapon of choice. When folk do you wrong and do you dirty, knowing what they're doing, that's all right. God says, amen. Jesus is my weapon of choice. I'm going to forgive you in spite of your situation. When people, amen, might forget about you, leave you, amen, and abandon you, amen. My weapon of choice is the word of God that tells me that God is with me and he will never leave me nor forsake me. That's my weapon of choice. I can fight. I ain't got to be no victim no more. Don't be a victim. Be a victor in Jesus Christ by trusting God, by worshiping him, trusting God by praising to him, trusting God by using the word of God, trusting God by praying, trusting God by worshiping, trusting God by being a living testimony, trusting God by living for God. Somebody say my weapon of choice. I don't know what yours is, but if it ain't Jesus, you need to throw it away. Somebody said, but as for me, my weapon of choice is Jesus. Somebody give God a hand of praise. Come on, somebody. Just give God a hand of praise. Jesus is my weapon of choice. It will never lose. It will never fail. It will never fall short. All you got to do is call it. Somebody know, anybody know how to call it? I'm talking about when you're sick and you're down and you don't know what else to say. Jesus, call it. Don't try to fret, don't try to, amen, power it up, don't try to dress it up. Just call his name, Jesus! Call him, he knows that call. He knows what to do when you call that way. Call him from your belly, Jesus! Hallelujah, when that devil get on your back, amen. Start speaking the word of God. Let folk think you crazy, but that's all right. Sometimes we got to get to crazy so we can get to Jesus. Somebody say, amen, Jesus is my weapon of choice. Start speaking to that situation. People think you're crazy. He said, and my God shall provide all my needs according to my riches and glory. Yeah, this too shall pass. Yes, God for me is greater than the world against me. Yeah, I'm going through trial and tribulation now. But amen, the best is yet to come. I dare you, amen, to trust God and his word. Jesus is my weapon of choice. Somebody give God a hand of praise. Jesus is my weapon of choice. Some of us live in a fairy tale land. Still, you're going to go through hardship. You're going to go through tough times. You're going to go through heartache and heartbreak. You're going to go through ups and downs. Just because you're a child of God, you're not immune to bad times. But the good news is that we have weapons of our warfare that are not carnal. Amen. Carnal means we take worldly things into a spiritual battle and expect spiritual results. It won't happen. But if you just try Jesus, ask Paul and Silas, they begin to praise God and they're about to get their heads cut off.
Yes.
They begin to praise God and pray. Yes. The Bible said God came and shook that place.
Yes.
Somebody need God to shake your place. Some of us got some stuff hanging on us that he needs to shake off. And not only that, their praise and their spiritual weapons were so powerful and mighty in Christ that the other prisoners that were locked up, God shook it. Y'all don't hear me here. When you praise God for your belly, somebody else, God is shaking somebody else's stuff up. Yes. Just because you decide to praise him.
Yes.
Don't you know if somebody is in the vicinity of what God is blessing, no matter who they are, God will bless them too. Yes. When you testify of the goodness of God, don't you know somebody's sitting there scared to open their mouth? And just because you testify to the goodness of the Lord, somebody's been set free because now they truly believe they're not by themselves. So your testimony is powerful. You tell that devil if he didn't kill me when I was in the dope house, ain't nothing he can do to me now. Ain't nothing he can do to me. I don't know about you. Ain't nothing he can do to me that my God won't allow him. And if God allow him, well, then God be the glory.
Yes. Show enough. Hallelujah.
Oh yeah, you got to be radical for this. Because the devil is radical. And you go in there tiptoeing, you won't get run over. You better fight. Tell your neighbor, fight. Fight. I don't care what it is. Fight. you better fight. Shoelace. Fight. If you got a scratch your throat, fight. If you don't fight, you're going to faint.
Yes.
And if you don't fight, you're going to faint and you're going to get sifted like me. If you're weak and you can't do it no more, God says, my strength is perfected in your weakness.
Yes.
It's all right to be weak. It's all right to cry and boo-hoo and just call it like, Jesus, I can't do it no more. Lord, help me. Don't be like, Lord, help me. I'm just finishing late. Just help me. He in it. Because you ain't saying it like you really mean it. God bless you, my dear one. Might there be somebody who knows the Lord and part of their sin. Might be somebody who needs salvation. You're not saved. You've been coming to church, but you ain't saved. Might it be you? Why don't you come? Is there anybody here that might want to join Triumphant Jude Praise Ministries? If you're here and you'd like to join this ministry, you should come. We are, God is doing a great work in this church. Why don't you come? If that's you today, why don't you come? Last week, God brought a host of folk up. But God wants to see us often. Amen. He don't want to see us on occasion. I'm so glad, thank God, that he don't bless us on occasion. Because we'd be in trouble. But I thank God for his mercy and his grace. Amen. You may be seated. God's blessing to all of you again. Thank you for being with us today. Amen. At the Triumph of Judah Praise Ministries, let us all at this time just say thank you,
thank you.
To all who participated today. Amen. For those who came, Tony Paul and Mother Rice, thank you for coming in. They were members with me over in Newark. Amen. And I thank God for them. We had members of my old church in Asbury Park last week up here. Amen. The word is getting out. But what are you doing about growing your church? Amen. If you're ashamed to tell somebody about your church, what you doing here? Amen. Amen. Let us all stand. Let us all stand for our benediction. Amen. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling and able to present us faultless before his throne with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Lord, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and ever. Let the church say, amen.
Amen.
God bless you. Go in peace. Until we meet again, God bless you.